Shall we try this again? Hi. Sorry, I don't know what loves to happen with my internet. So I just upgraded, so it's really nice internet. Maybe it's just Facebook, because I actually don't have these problems on Zoom, but I seem to only have them on Facebook. Maybe it's my camera. I don't know. I don't know what it is. But hey guys, I hope you're back. Yay! So hi Ingrid. Sorry, thanks for finding me again. So if you missed my whole spiel, I'm just gonna do the short version. I think I sprained my ankle or I hurt it somehow when I was sleeping. So it's a good thing we're on the mats today. We're gonna stay on the mats and we're gonna start with some stretching. So grab your towels. If you missed what I said, because I was frozen and I didn't realize it, you will need at least two towels or a towel and a yoga strap. One long towel, one short towel. It can be two long towels. Just make sure one of them is at least long. I'm gonna do my best to not do anything. There are gonna be times when I might say flex your foot or point your foot, and I'm probably not gonna be able to point my foot. That's the way it really hurts. And so, as always, as the theme of this class is we don't do anything that hurts, right? So we're not afraid to get a little uncomfortable, but we've got to be real clear with ourselves on the difference between discomfort and pain. And when that discomfort is from muscle fatigue, and when that discomfort is causing, and even when discomfort, because I know a lot of us are tough, like real tough, and we'll push through things, be like, oh yeah, I can take it. This is not really painful. It just hurt. If it's like anything that doesn't feel like your muscles are tired, I want you to find a different position. Take a modification. Your body will thank you. Your body is probably going through all kinds of heck right now. We'll just keep it clean. But we want to be really kind to ourselves through this. So let's start on our backs. And we're actually just going to start with just a little flip-flop of the knees side to side. I've been liking to start like this. It's a little weird, but go with me. We're just flip-flopping our knees back and forth. And I'm trying to keep my ankles kind of straight here. So I'm just really letting the knees do this wishwash windshield wiper tip motion. It's back and forth. I'm gonna actually change my camera view real quick so that I can see what you see. I'm sorry if I'm looking over here. It's not that I'm like checking my email in the middle of the live. It's because you guys, I can see the view and any comments over here, even though my camera is over here. So thanks for your patience with that. I know that sometimes not always clear. So, I'm going to flip-flop or windshield wiper my knees back and forth and just be very mindful of your ankles. So, mine aren't even feeling so great doing this. So, I'm going to keep my feet a little flatter. I do prefer this one in pointed toes, so like up on your toes, but I'm going to keep my feet a little flatter because that's what my body needs today. Definitely, again, do not push through pain. Take care of yourselves, please. And then let's just add a little swoosh. So just add a little swoosh side to side. And this is, does not need to be fancy. I know it looks kind of fancy, but all I'm doing is I'm flopping my knees to one side. This top leg just keeps going with that momentum. And I'm trying to actually keep that toe down. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm trying to keep that down so you feel that lovely stretch of the hips. But it's not a static stretch. We're just moving through this. So just trying to get the whole body just all. Did you hear that? Yeah, that's the foot that I'm having the problems with. And that has been happening to me for years. That snap, I know what it is. I just can't get it to go away. So I can't get it fixed. I probably need surgery. And I'm just like ignoring that fact. So. Been to several doctors. None of them have said surgery, but nobody's given me anything that has fixed it. So, working through it. If you have a foot specialist you love, feel free to give me a recommendation. If you are a foot specialist who specializes in hypermobile ankles and feet or unstable ankles and feet, please talk to me. And we'll just do a few more of these. This is just to kind of get our backs and our hips moving. And last one. Okay, let's come around onto our knees. This is gonna look like a cat cow, but I want you to pretend it's a whole new movement that you have never done before. So I'm going to arch my back and look up, like, what is up there, and be insanely curious about your ceiling. And then I'm going to flip my toes and gently press in and be insanely curious about your belly button.
You don't need to flip your, do a hair flip like that. You really should go slowly. So you will probably miss my face for a bit. It's okay.
It's not that interesting. And be insanely curious about your ceiling.
I'm insanely curious about your belly button.
And all I'm doing is just rocking as I change position to flip my toes. I just shift my weight into my hands.
I'm trying to arch my back there. I know it doesn't look like it.
My back doesn't arch a lot.
But I'm trying to really stick the tailbone up, almost like I'm trying to look not just to my ceiling, but as if I'm trying to look overhead and see my own butt from this position. So if you imagine that that could be possible, if you really looked hard enough and think length through the back of your neck, we're not trying to scrunch the back of the neck. We're just trying to get some length through both sides of the body. Really reaching. And last one. Okay, we'll press up to a down dog. I'm going to see how that feels for me. If I can't stay in it, you guys stay in it. We'll press up to a down dog or just an upside down V. Well, that feels kind of good.
So I'm just going to pedal out my feet. So this is feeling fine. And then go ahead and have both heels down if that feels okay for you, sending your hips up to the ceiling. And yes, this is Pilates, it's not yoga, but this is a fine move for us to do. I think it's great for us. It's a great little stretch. With this position, this down dog position, or this upside down V, it's kind of like an upside down teaser if you want to relate it to Pilates. I do want you to think about, instead of your shoulders being down, I want you to think about your shoulders like really, it's like you're trying to push the ground away. So the shoulders are kind of up by your ears, but in a very safe and supportive manner. And then walk it in just a little. You'll take one hand and take it to the outside of the opposite ankle. So I took my right hand to the outside of my left ankle, and you could do the opposite, whatever works for you. And just kind of looking under your armpit. And then switch. And then switch. Just do that again. And then switch. Okay.
Shaking that out. Let's go onto our backs and we'll do a little bit of a roll down or half roll down. So I've got at least Ingrid here. If you're here and you want to say hi, please feel free. We're going to stay on the mats today if you missed it. I think I've sprained my ankle or definitely damaged it in some way. So we're not going to be up on our feet today. We'll just be down here. So we're going to hold on to the backs of our thighs and just roll on down, just a half roll down. So I'm just trying to get maybe to my low back, maybe not even that far, and then I'll come on up. And I keep my toes pressing into the ground as much as possible. I may have to change that, but if you can keep those the toes, the feet, 100% on the ground, that's what we're going for here. We're rounding down, and keep your eyes open. I'm looking, not crunching at my belly button, but I'm kind of looking out this way. And then that's the thing that I'm trying to go back to. Something that may be a little higher than your eye line when you're seated. We're just trying to keep our eyes there and come on up. And I like to talk about the focus a lot because there is just something when our eyes are open and we're really seeing something that engages the muscles just in our backs, in our shoulders, in a way that we really just can't get unless we have that very clear focus. Like I'm literally looking at the dots, the power button on my television, very specifically, like it's the most interesting thing in the world. And that focus is helping to keep my neck in really good alignment, keep all the muscles engaged. And we're taking it down and we're just gonna hold it here, just finding some length. So now I'm gonna pick something maybe even a little higher than what I was looking at before, something that is out on this diagonal to help me find length through both sides of my body. My back is rounding. I'm trying to scoop my abs under. I struggle with this so much. This is one of my biggest challenges in Pilates type movements. It's why I love it. I'm gonna bring my knees up toward this tabletop position and just keeping this lovely long scoop. So I could crunch up and push all the muscles forward. This isn't fat, this is all muscle. So don't be shy about, it's not being shy about the muscles sticking out. It's just about trying to find some muscles that are a little deeper. So reset if you need to, finding those muscles that are below those six pack muscles and just holding here. Hold, 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 hold. Looking, 3, 2, 1, and hug the knees into the chest and squeeze. I saw this lovely thing online about our bodies through this quarantine, and someone was saying, like, your body is handling you and keeping you going through one of the most stressful things it's ever had to go through. And so please don't be mad at it if it does get a little softer in some places through the process, right? Like, love your body for getting you through this. Let's pull, 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 pull. And even more importantly, listen to your body when it's saying something is off. Pull, 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 pull. If this starts to bother your neck, listen to your body. It's saying, my neck's tired. I've been slumped over a desk all day. So let your neck rest. And then find how you can engage your abs without being in that position. You're so capable of that creativity. The body is capable. So exhale, exhale. See if you find your abs there. And then start to take the hands away. So maybe you didn't feel your abs with your head down, with your hands pulling on your legs, but do you feel them now? Pull, pull, pull that thigh in with just the strength of your abs and your breath. Pull, pull. Here's the place where we can really get in touch with that breathing. We don't have to be shy. I get shy in class. I tell you guys to breathe audibly, but I'm such a shy person. And if I'm in a group class, I don't want to be that person making noise, right? And one, hug the knees into the chest and squeeze. So I love quarantine because I can make all the noise I want and I'm on mute. No one can hear me. So single straight leg sweep, pull, 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 pull. Pull, pull. Take stock of your body while you're doing this. You guys keep going. I'm just checking out the, hey, Rachel, I just saw your comment. Pull, 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 pull. We're thinking of length through the body. Pull, 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 pull. Let's take our hands away and let's see if we can match that range that we found with the help of our hands. Even if your head is down, even if your knees are a little bent, even if your toes aren't perfectly pointed, find what feels good for you. Pull, pull, no pinching, but a good challenge. Let's do 2, let's do 1, and hug the knees into the chest and squeeze. Okay, you guys. Let's do a little double leg stretch right here. I know the necks might be a little tired, but I think we've got this. If you wanna rest your head, please feel free. Just make sure your back feels okay. We curl forward, exhale, and then send it all out. We curl forward, curl in. And I just caught myself cheating. So I see there's this big space under my butt. I'm gonna try to keep that down and send it on out. Really try to feel the contact of those bones in the backs of your hips on the ground. So that entire lower back, those hips are staying on the ground. And we're trying to find what is our true fold here with our abs pulled in and that staying down, and send it out. And it might not be as much as you thought it was. And that's, I think, the interesting thing. It's okay if it's not as much. Like, it's, oh, there's an opportunity there, right? Take it out. Sorry, I'm in total like Coach Kathryn mode. And out, hug the knees into the chest. You may not know this, but I am a professional coach. Or this is not a sales pitch whatsoever, but I am a professional coach. Like, you can call it a life coach. I kind of hate that term, but just because there's so many weird connotations with it. Lift the legs straight up and we'll flex and take it down. Flex and take it down. But I am a coach, certified. I went to school for it. Like, got multiple certifications to my name, so I'm not just a person who was like,
Hey, I think I live an interesting life. I'm going to coach other people. Not like I'm trained to do it. But anyway, some days I end up coaching through my entire classes, and it becomes super like motivational speaker, Kathryn. Everything has a higher or deeper meaning. So I'm flexing my feet and pointing my toes, flexing and pointing. I might not have a very big point today, so if you can point really beautifully through those feet, you do it for me because I can't. I'm going to try to squeeze my ankles together. And by the way, it's okay if your body only goes a little bit here. I would rather, in fact, that you make it smaller and think reach, 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 and maybe stop there than putting your hands under your hips. You can. But I would love for you to find where is that range where you don't have to contort your spine. What is possible for your body, and challenge it even within a tiny range, and appreciate it for the range that it has. Taking it and bringing it up, and taking it and bringing it up. Hug the knees into the chest and squeeze. I'm gonna go into a tiny little glute bridge series here. Planting our feet, we're just lifting our hips up. We may have done some of this on Tuesday. I apologize if there's a lot of repetition. I had a plan for the day and then had to wake up and scrap it. Breaking it up. I've had classes all morning and all of them have been like a complete improvisation just based on this ankle that has thrown a little bit of a curveball into my day. Lifting up. But anything we did on Tuesday, it's not a bad idea to repeat it on Thursday. So some of it's the same. It's still great for our bodies. We're lifting up. I want you to think of this like an active stretch for the tops of your thighs and fronts of your hips. So we're trying to lengthen through the top of our legs from the hip to the knee. And sure, that means the booty has to engage. But if we think of it as a stretch, maybe we'll push a little higher into it. Try to keep the ribs in. So notice the difference when I'm here, really lifting from down here versus lifting from my back. So it kind of looks like I know it's not a good position for me because I can no longer see any parts of my legs. All I see is my ribs. So if I keep that in and I really think lift from underneath, I can see most of my legs. And that's my little, for me, that works. Different bodies, that may not be the best guide, but for me, that works, and maybe that helps you. Let's hold it up. I want you to hold here and really feel not just underneath, but see how your glutes are working, how they're showing up today. Is one glute showing more up more than the other? Is one feeling tight? Is one feeling higher or lower? Maybe you need to adjust your feet. So just getting connected here and lift 1 inch higher. If you need to support your back from underneath while we're figuring this out, go for it. So lift 1 inch higher if you can. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Holding here for four, for three, for two, for one. Okay, lower it down. Awesome. We're going to do some more leg lifts and lowers. And this time I want you to have something you can squeeze between your ankles. So a rolled up towel is great. I like something lightweight. I have done this with a yoga block, but my yoga blocks are these super heavy cork yoga blocks. And that is just way too much for me. If you can do it, go for it. Sure, if it feels good for you. I'm going to use a ball. But you don't have to have, like a rolled up towel will work just as well, maybe even better. We just want to squeeze it between our ankles. Maybe grab a pillow off of your couch. Like, honestly, I could do this with this pillow, folding it over. Oh, that's fantastic, right? So I'm gonna use that. Shoot, I'm gonna use a ball. It's too wiggly. I'm gonna do this leg lift and lower action. I'm gonna try to work through some flexing and pointing of the feet, but that may not happen as easily here. That's okay. I just wanna think about this connection in, trying to squeeze and feel that connection all the way up into the very tops of my thighs. I'm lowering down, super controlled, and coming on up. I'm lowering down again, super controlled. Just feel how the work changes when our focus is someplace else. Like, so yes, I'm using my abs still. If you want to, one thing that sometimes helps me instead of putting hands under the hips, is I either push into the floor and I'm pushing like down and away, Or I hold the sides of my mat and I push down in a way, like I'm almost trying to stretch my mat. That really helps me to keep a nice neutral back. And you know, I'm talking a mile a minute too. I've got like adrenaline from improv and pain, probably all coursing through my system right now. And bring it up and take it down. And bring it up, take it down, and bring it up. Keep going there, take it down, and bring it up. So good, guys, just looking at comments. Sorry, take it down, and bring it on, take it down, and bring it on up. And then we're going to take it down and hold it. Just hold it there, just hold. And you know, it feels so good. Squeeze the thighs, reach long through the legs, like someone is pulling on your legs. We hold for four, for three, for two. For one, okay, I totally was like, for one, I didn't hold it, sorry. We're gonna elevate our hips now. I'm gonna use the same pillow. I'm improvising with the pillow. This one, this next one, if you have a yoga block or a foam roller, that's even the best thing. I'm just gonna put this under my hips though, and have one leg up, and then the other leg is just down. And so feeling how when the hips are a little elevated, how it has to, you can either just hang there, right? Or we can think, stretch it down. So what I'd like you to do here is just have maybe a little bend through this leg, hold on to this leg, and then reach this other leg. Just think, squeeze your butt down. Squeeze it down. We're not just letting it hang and fall. I'm keeping my abs engaged, and I'm squeezing it down. Squeezing it down. Squeezing it down. See how much squeeze you can find here. This is one where you really have to be aware with your body, try to get that glute to engage, to pull a little stretch. If you want to be lifted onto a higher surface than what you have, maybe you're like, I'm feeling it, but I could be feeling it so much more. Feel free to grab something that is a little higher. So this rolled up towel or this rolled up pillow, this was maybe about the size of my yoga block, but maybe not when I was sitting on it. I'm gonna try it on my yoga block now. Same idea though. I don't want it to hurt my back. I have one leg up. It can be slightly bent. And the other leg, I'm just squeezing down. Squeezing down. Just trying to get some stretch. A foam roller is my favorite thing for this one. Squeeze it down. Squeeze it down. Notice if one side of your leg feels tighter. Squeeze it down. For me, it's always the inside of my leg feels a little tighter. For you, it might be the opposite. Squeeze it down. And last one, I'm gonna do this on the other side. So what we're working here is we're working on, this is the back leg of your splits if you're working on splits. So squeeze, because ideally in our splits, we want not just to be sitting and pushing against, hoping gravity will take us to the floor, right? We wanna be in control of it the whole time. Squeeze it down. So try to find your under butt here, try to find your side butt here to help pull you down. Squeeze it down. Squeeze it down. Right now. If anything feels like pinchy, you don't have to touch the floor, by the way. So you could just be here. Just, I'm feeling a little pinch, so I'm going to back off of it. Squeeze it down. I'm sorry, I didn't say this on the other side in case you push through pinch. But you wouldn't have because we made a deal that you're not going to push through anything that's really painful. Squeeze it down. I think it's actually harder to not touch the floor. And two. And one. Okay. Wiggle that out. Oh my goodness. We're going to come on to our tummies and we'll do some really fun hamstring work. Hamstring work is just so hard for a lot of us. It's good for us, but it's so hard. We're on our tummies. Let's go ahead and let's actually just start for just a moment just to get our backs feeling okay. I'm just going to look up. And then look down. And up. And down. And up. And down. And up. And down. Okay, from here, I would like you to lift your, actually let's stay in our Sphinx. I think I like this better here. We're gonna bring our knees in or bring our heels in, keep your knees where they are and squeeze, like you're trying to squeeze something behind your knees. Squeeze, and I'm pushing up slightly and letting myself look up Just in my eye line, not crunching, not looking to the ceiling yet. Squeezing here. Squeezing. And you may not be feeling anything in your hamstrings. I'll be honest, I don't feel very much. So what helps me in that situation is, one, I could come up higher, like into more of a cobra, but what will help me more is just doing a little double pulse while I'm there. So I pulse, 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 pulse. You might try just doing one leg at a time and see if you feel that more. For me, that's usually the best because it forces me to keep my hips down. And it comes from my hips being so tight in the front that my hamstrings aren't engaging properly in the back. I can't get my feet, my legs into quite the right position for them to fire. Pull, pull. So if you were fine doing this with both legs, keep that up. If this is feeling awesome for you, you keep this up. And again, heel to booty. Try to kick my butt for real. Try to keep my hips down. And I am trying to bring my legs straight in, although my legs are slightly, I would say they are probably slightly externally rotated for me. Because again, my hips are super tight through the front, and that's the only way I can get into a position where my hamstrings even fire. And the most important thing is really, like, we want to be in these ideal, perfect positions. The most important thing for me is that we're feeling it in the right spots. Just trying to get these muscles to fire. Okay, we're going to take this down into a swimmer exercise. We'll start with our head on our forehead, our head on our forehead. Yes, I hope your forehead is attached to your head. But then we're going to attach that to the backs of our hands. Laying down. We'll just take a little flutter here. Reach those legs long. I'm just fluttering. So if, guys, I can't teach pop Pilates through these types of classes, but if I maybe were to add a pop Pilates to my own schedule, like a midday one kind of at this time or 10 o'clock, like what would work for you guys? Let me know. I tried doing it the first week, but I don't think we were all quite ready or connected then. But let me know if there's a time that would really work for you guys, or if I talk to Maddie about a time that we could do maybe a Zoom class through Balance. I don't know if that's possible, but I would really love to be able to see you guys. I want to see your faces, and I want to work with you. So let me know. At the end, keep doing this flutter. Don't get out of the flutter. Okay, take a rest. These flutter kicks are so hard. We're going to go into one using our arms if you're ready for it. So you're going to keep the legs doing the same things. Let's do one more set here. Arms go out by your ears. You're looking down, but not letting your head hang. Just looking down, moving through those arms and fluttering the legs while trying to keep the hips relatively still. We keep going here. You keep working. Yes. Reach long. It's like someone's pulling on your arms and pulling on your legs. I know you look amazing. I can't see you right now, but you look amazing, I'm sure. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, y'all. Let's come on to our sides. Let's do a little oblique work, and then we'll stretch, and then we're done. So a little oblique work. Now, again, not the hardest class in the world. I recognize that. But maybe still enough just to get you out of your whatever headspace you were in and get you into your bodies. So I'm taking my bottom arm and I'm taking it perpendicular to my body, stacking my hips, squeezing my thighs together. And I'm going to just lift up. Lift up. If you feel neck pain, here's my tip. Hand behind your head. Almost lean back into it. Change something else, like find something else to look at. For me, I have to look maybe a little higher than my own eye line. If this feels super easy to you, so long as you're keeping the ribs in and not rolling back, you could take this arm out by your ears. We're lifting up and up and up. And let's do one more here. Now let's take it in threes. We'll go up 3, 2, 1, and down. Take it 3, 2,
one, down, three, two, one, down, three, two, one, and down. Awesome. Let's do that on the other side. So just swing the legs around. That's a fun exercise in and of itself, just the swing around. Maybe we'll do that one day. So taking that arm perpendicular to your body, stacking the hips, squeeze the thighs, squeeze the ankles. Ooh, okay. Squeeze the ankles and point your toes only if your ankles feel up to it. Sorry. That was the like surprise of pain in a new place. Lifting up. Just notice your neck. If the neck is angry, it could be that you're kind of looking down this way. So try to get it all aligned. So for me, I almost lean back into my hand. I look a little above my eye line and I try to follow an arc with my eyes. So I'm just keeping my head in really good alignment with the rest of my spine. Because the rest of the day, it's not going to be like that. This is my one moment to really pay attention to that. And then we'll take it up in three as we go up. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. And three, two, one. Okay. Coming onto our backs. We'll do one last little ab push and then we'll stretch and then be done. Did I say obliques and then we'd be done? I'm sorry. I meant obliques and abs. I'm not really sorry. You know that. My knees are going to be stacked right over my hips. I'm keeping a neutral back. I'm just doing these toe touches. We talked about this, like imagining we're like some kind of doll or action figure and our legs are just molded into this shape where all we can do is bend at the hips, but our knees are incapable of changing the bend. If you're not sure if you are changing the bend, put your two rolled up towels behind your knees. It works really well. So just dropping down. And down. And two. And one. Now we're going to do something a little weird. You know, go into external rotation. You may feel your side butt a bit here. You may not have very much range of motion. But my toes are together and my knees are apart. My feet are in line with my center. And I'm just going to lower one down and then the other. If you feel a big crunching or pulling through your hips or your inner thighs, so notice I'm not touching the ground. That's because there's a spot that if I go past that, it's going to go crunch. It doesn't really hurt, but it makes a popping sensation that is not a productive pop. So I'm just lowering down. And what I'm doing here is I'm getting a lovely stretch for this part of my leg while also working my abs in this incredibly challenging position to hold. Because things aren't quite aligned. Your knees and leg bones aren't quite aligned in the same, they're not aligned in the same way as in a tabletop, which is, so it's just harder. It's much more of a challenge. You might feel your inner thighs. That's okay. I'm starting to feel more pops even right here. So I'm going to keep it smaller. I'm going to try to engage more of my side butt. See if that helps to take any of those pop sensations away, even if this is just a tiny move. And I know you can't really quite see what I'm doing. So I'll just right from here, I'm just going down and down and down and down. We have four. We have three. You have two and one. Okay. Hug the knees into the chest and squeeze. I'm going to stay right here because for this next one, we're just going to be shaking a little of that out. All I'm going to do is I'm bringing my knees in and then I'm going to send them out. I don't know if I have enough room. You're only going to see my legs and that's okay. I'm going in. And we'll reverse this. So if you're going the opposite way, that's fine. I know it makes a lot of noise. Sorry. Okay. We're going now in and out. And notice if there's one way that your hips love and one way that they don't love as much. Remember, you can make this super small. You could barely be moving. You could just be going in and out. Maybe not even all the way. If you can get a big internal and external rotation, awesome.
But if it's not working for you, don't force your legs into anything that feels painful. Even if it feels kind of like a good stretch, there are so many nerves through here that we just don't want to irritate. So make sure if that you're feeling a stretch, it's like a 3 out of 10. No more than that. And if you've been have any sciatic nerve stuff that you've been working with a doctor on, I would check with them before doing anything like this just to be sure that it's okay for you. Because we are working through the nervous system a bit here. And one more. Okay.
Hopefully that felt really good. It feels really good to me. We'll take a little windmill, not as an exercise, but as a... Okay, we have still have 5 minutes. I thought it was over time. So we're going to take a windmill, more like a stretch than like an exercise. I still want you to keep your shoulder blades down, though. So we'll take it over. And take it over. So we're not thinking about this being the hardest oblique exercise. At the same time, we're not going to let our shoulders, and by shoulders, I mean the entire shoulder blade, your entire upper back, we're not letting that lift up. So to get the most effective stretch, I'm going to think about squeezing my ankles and knees together, pushing my arms into the ground, the whole back of my arms, thinking of my arms as starting from the middle of my back and just taking it over. And one thing I actually really like in this is squeezing something between my ankles, like a little hand towel. I'm gonna use my slippers. So, because it just reminds me to keep everything together so it moves as one piece. Because sometimes if there's just that little shift, I don't get quite the same release. And again, not trying to be cruel to our bodies, but like listening to our bodies and where they want to go, but also just giving them those opportunities to move parts of the body, to move independently from other parts, which is, you know, sometimes like, the lower part of the body wants to be get a little space from the upper part of the body. I'm sure if you live with someone, you understand that. My boyfriend and I are great because he still has to leave the house every day. So I know if you live alone, this is an especially challenging time. I know that it can be just as challenging if you have a partner and a very small space to be in. So, especially with children who have no sense of boundaries. So we all have our different challenges to face. Shake that out. Let's do a little just mobilization of our for our legs. Let's use that towel that I asked you to bring. Because wouldn't that be cruel if I was like, get this thing, and then you dug it out of the laundry or whatever, and then we didn't use it. I'm going to take my yoga strap. I'm taking my towel. If you have two towels and one is smaller than the other, just make the smaller one the one you're putting under your low back. I am just rolling this up, so it's really skinny. It's not a big bolster under my back. I'm not trying to force my lower back into an unnatural position. I'm just trying to remember that there's a curve there. Remind myself. I'm also trying to keep something down. I think this would be an interesting thing to do with a fan with a piece of paper under your hips, like so that the fan would blow the piece of paper away if your hip lifted up. It's just a thought there. So let's start with your foot planted. If you have a towel or a strap, don't put it right over your toes. Put it right around like the arch of your foot. And I'm going to start with a bent knee, pulling it in while trying to keep this hip down. And so just pulling it in and releasing it, pulling it in and releasing it and pulling it in, anchoring that hip, pull it in and pull it in. Okay, and I'm gonna lengthen up and down. I'm trying to not let my knee leave my chest, so you may not feel any stretch whatsoever when you do this. And if you don't, it's okay. This is not intended to feel like a hamstring stretch just yet. So for me, I do feel a little tugging or pulling on the inside of my thigh. And that is where I have some like nerve tightness. If you feel absolutely nothing at all, that is totally fine. Keep doing it. So that's exactly like make sure your knee isn't moving, make sure your tailbone is down, that you still have a slight arch in your back, just the tiniest arch in your low back. And then if you want to, you could extend this leg out
But again, it should not feel, if it feels like anything, any kind of stretch whatsoever, it's not really what we're going for. And just make sure it's not anything more than like a 2 or 3 out of 10. Okay. And now I'm going to actually bring this up to a planted foot so that it helps me to really keep this anchor of this tailbone down. And I'm going to pull in gently with a very slight micro bend. So I'm not trying to force a stretch here. I'm not trying to force myself into a position, let's say. I'm not trying to force my foot to my face. I'm trying more to think about anchoring this part of my body so that this can lengthen. And that's part of also why I'm keeping a slight bend in my knee, because it will help me to feel this attachment point so that it's not just all around the knee. And I'm having a little trouble feeling that today. So I'm going to play with some different angles. So I'm going to take it slightly across my body, keeping the hip down. I'm not lifting my butt up. I'm keeping that hip down. I'm just pulling slightly across. And then slightly out, not my biggest stretch. Slightly across, just moving side to side. And just feeling what sensations are happening there as I go in and out. And just keeping my hip really still and just allowing the leg to move. Okay, if you want to do this with your leg out, that's awesome. Fine, that's great. One thing you can play with if that leg is out is activating through your booty on that side, like we were doing when we had our hips on the block. Awesome. Let's just do like one more side to side. Cool. Really small, like not going for contortion stretching today. And let's just find it on the other side. So I would love to know if any of this stuff is interesting to you, helpful to you. I will go off on this tangent because it's so fascinating to me. But if you're like, no, Kathryn, could we just do more of a really challenging Pilates class, or I want to work on this or that, or if we want one day to be one and one to be the other. I mean, I just want to know what you guys want. It's not about me. Pulling in. But you letting me know what you'll show up for, also you help me the most, because then it means that I get to teach more, right? I get to keep teaching this class. If no one's showing up for it, why are they going to pay me to do it, right? So make it something you want to show up for. So I'm pulling in, and now I'm going to really think pull my knee in and just lifting up and down. You want to extend the other leg, you can. I'm going to keep it right here. I think everything for me needs to be a little dialed back today. And again, though, remembering with this one, the biggest stretch you're going to get, like you might be getting a gigantic stretch, you're just not going to feel it. So it's a very specific type of thing we're doing that's not a muscle stretch. So you're probably not going to feel anything, or if you feel anything at all, it's really minor. So don't let yourself go into something like that. That's not what we're doing right now. Okay, cool. Now that we have gotten that like nice and awake, now we can extend it out and really anchor that tailbone down, keep a natural curve, slight bend behind that knee and pull in and just see how it feels. I am feeling like something so lovely happening to my other leg, the one we were just mobilizing. I feel like maybe something was really locked up in my hip and now it feels like the blood is finally flowing. It might have had something to do with the leg being like this for a while, but elevated, and then now blood is flowing back into it. That actually makes more sense, but it feels good, whatever it is. Side to side. I thought I had found something magic, and then I thought about it, and I was like, right, this is why I'm not a doctor. Or this is more evidence that I'm not a doctor. Out and in, just out. And again, all of this feeling really within a good, safe, happy range, nothing painful. Okay, guys, I think that's about at our time. So let's just do like one more lovely little stretch. What I'd love to do, just because I've been thinking about this a lot, is doing crisscross applesauce. Oh yeah. Oh my gosh, we're over time. I can't do it. We gotta save it for, I'll save it for like bar class on Saturday. Talk to me guys though about what you want in class. Let's take a big inhale. Exhale. You cannot trust me with anything timed. Inhale.
Exhale. I will go over every single time. Give yourselves a giant hug because you took some time out for yourself today. DM me with what like would work for you if you want to do like a pop class or something. Let me know. Talk to you guys. Thank you guys for showing up today. Appreciate you.